Can you smell that?
Ooh. Ooh. Dr. Foster surgery. Okay, wait, can I take that with me? Okay, I can. Sweet. I'll leave the leave the binoculars in there. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's go do that immediately. Let's see, his place was over here. Yeah. Well, I think at this point I've pretty much made a full circle. Yeah, doctor's place is on the opposite side of the pinwheel cinema. Okay, Vicky, at 14:30. Now, what about the date? It doesn't say, does it? Oh, I suppose I can try them all. Brute force. The best method. Something tells me this isn't gonna work. I mean, if you look, the times are going... The dates are advancing. You know, 17th, 19th, 28th, 29th. Except I was thinking 30th, 31st. Apparently not, and again, shit. This is not how you're supposed to solve puzzles. I don't recommend this, kids. Do not try this at home. This isn't gonna work, is it? Whatever, I give up. I'm doing really, 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 really bad on the puzzles in this area. Like, horrendously bad. Alright, I don't think I've been in here. Wait, no, wait. Yes, I have. Right? Maybe I haven't. Maybe this just looked familiar because I remember. Isn't this where I started in, like, one of my memories? Yeah, I recognize this here. This room, the stairs, this gas mask. Yeah. So, yeah, I actually think I have been here. Like, I think I explored it, right? Need to find a note. See if I've read it before.
Can you smell that?
Let's see. Yeah, I've definitely been here. Okay. So is there anywhere left to explore?
Hey, I've got another one. Why was 6 scared? Because 7, 8, 9.
No, please no. Oh, there we go. I can put that on the thing back at the school. Circle X, nothing X, circle, circle. Alright, so I have not explored here, and I need to go put that at the school.
Okay, how about this one? Why do milking stalls have 3 legs? Because the cows have the udder. Then it's, how could you not remember you were cooking? You could have burnt the house down.
Okay, so that should have restored this partially, right? One part restored. But again, that's not what doing this did. This bell did something else. Damn this school to hell. I hate it. Pinwheel. Barbara, Pinwheel is beautiful. You must come with me one day. I'm staying in room number 5, which is a little smaller than I'm usually used to, but the view is great. I can see down over the town square and the May Day celebrations. The toilet is down on the first floor, though, and it's very cold in the night by the sea. Anyway, hope to see you soon. Ben. I really wanted to disturb whoever was in there. Even if it's only disturbing their spectral memories. It's for nausea. Ooh. 1410. Found in wallet. Peter Disler's wallet. Peter Disler. I wrote down Pete's name as being someone who's maybe going to the hospital. That was in one of the other buildings. Was there a code? Do I need a code to unlock something in his building, like a safe? There's gotta be, right? Wait a minute. Now I know his last name. Let's try it. Write it down. Peter Disler. But then again, if it's his name that I do need to enter, then what about the thing I found? the medical thing. Which is something completely different. This is Vicky. This is cozy, isn't it? Sit down in front of the fireplace. Look at a gigantic picture of a guy in a fancy suit with a gun. Yeah. Then we'll post May 2nd, 1966. Obituaries. For the week beginning May 1st, 1966. R. Burton. Okay, let's see if there's any names I recognize. Oh, G. Thornton. That's gotta be George, my father. Or, I guess not my father. G's father. Oh, Sean V. He was one of the mine workers. L. Disler. L. Disler. Obviously related to Peter Disler.
Is it me, or does his carpet smell?
Smells like pixels. Could use that to dig something up. Maybe the capsule. It's a hand trowel or whatever they call them. Trowel? Trowel? I'm not sure.
When was the last time I ate something?
I suppose I could do this, huh? Or you could also call it a shovel. I'd call it more like a mini shovel. Like a shovelette, if you will. Plant business. I have so many orders I can't keep up. I'm grateful for the business, though, considering how things have been going financially. I've just finished an order from Sean V. He wanted an extra special one for his wife for the May Day celebrations. Such a cute couple. Is that more coffee cleaner? It is. Hold on, where did I see a coffee maker? Where was it? Well, there's a coffee, like, percolator thing at the church. But this is for a drip. Feels like there should be more here. Wait, did I go upstairs? No, I didn't. In manager, Peter Disler. Oh, does he have a save up here? Yes, he does. Painter's Journal number 1. I've been told by my doctor that keeping a journal about my workshop work will be beneficial for my treatment, even at this early stage. Wait, have I read this? I feel like I've read this. Yeah, I did read this. Yeah, I've read that before. Fishing. Hitting the fresh air, the fresh sea air today did me a lot of... Wait, haven't I read this? Yeah, I've already read this too. Huh. I wonder if that means something, or if maybe the developers just wanted to put it here again just to make sure that it got seen. I don't know. Anyway, let's go get the code wheel. Where did I put you? There you are. There you are. Grave 1410.
Harry walked with his head slightly low and without making eye contact. Please don't hate me, Rob. Andrew made me do it. Rob shoved the lamp at Andrew. I don't hate you, Harry. Let's just get the hell out of here. Just then, Rob stopped in his tracks. Shh! Everyone! What was that noise? It's not gonna work, Andrew sighed. No, seriously, said Rob. I heard something. The brothers stood for a moment and listened. A pained groan whistled through one of the tunnels, connected to the main passageway. Oh, crap, shouted Rob. Tell me that's you again, Andy. Andrew's face dropped. No, that's nothing to do with me. Suddenly, knocking and banging 3 times louder than before, and moaning and yelling spilled from the mine, getting closer and closer. That's real, Andrew cried. Harry grabbed hold of Rob's arm. What are we gonna do?
I took that moment to get an eyelash out of my eye. It's really bothering me. Multitasking. I wonder how many parts of the collection there are. I really want to know where that story goes. There can't be too many more. Yeah, piece of toast. I'm gonna take that. It's going in my collection. Piece of toast. I'm sure it'll come in useful.
I've been asking around, and I've been doing a little research. I'm not happy about this whole thing. There has to be a better way for you, for all of us. Just say the word.
think that's it for this place. Okay, where does that leave me? Have I found all the projectors? Yes, I have. Okay.
The lost car keys finally turn up on the table by the front door.
The only doctor for 12 miles. This was a busy surgery. It says here, support doctors would have to be telegraphed weeks in advance, just so she could take a week's holiday.
I'm really not sure where to go from here. I'm gonna have a think about that, and I'll be right back. Alright, I've come to a conclusion. I'm really not enjoying this anymore. Not the game, but trying to solve every single projector. Like I said before, I wanted to 100% this. And at first I was totally for that. And then I think it's when I got to the Brimcliff Mines I thought, am I actually going to be able to do that? Am I really going to want to? And I had some doubts. And then I went back and I did some more projectors and I had some successes. So went from, yes, I'm going to 100% this, to, not sure, and then kind of back to, yeah, I think I can do this. But now? Now that I've been literally just running around this city? This village? For 20 to 30 minutes, making absolutely no progress whatsoever? Trying to think of even a single thing I can think of to do? I'm realizing that I don't have the patience. This has turned into a slog. I don't like it. So, as much as I wanted 100% it, and I'm totally gonna have to look this up on, I don't know, a wiki or something. Because I'm really curious, like, what's in the capsule and what's inside of this safe? I was so close! I just needed one more code wheel. Of course, I also need the combination, but yeah. I really don't want to leave those unsolved. I really do want to know their answers, but again, actually playing through this and trying to solve these puzzles is just, it's not interesting anymore. I don't like it. I don't know if it's just because I've been doing it for so long that it's just kind of grated on me, or if it's because the puzzles in this last section are just, they don't seem all that great. I don't know if they simply got harder, or if they're just not as well designed, I'm not really sure. But either way, I've only solved one. And the others, I have literally no idea. No idea. Not a single lead to think, oh, maybe I'll try... No. Nothing.
Okay, how about this one? Why do milking stalls have three legs? Because the cows have the udder.
Okay, that kind of lightened the mood. But yeah, I've spent like the past 20 minutes trying to find where this capsule's buried. Down from a school extension built over it, down from the church by the cliff. And I've just been running around trees, and that's not fun, that's not interesting. It's dumb. It's a waste of my time, I don't like it. I did discover something interesting though, let me demonstrate. It turns out, this little wall here has no collision mesh. Yep. No collision mesh whatsoever. I actually found a tree that had no collision mesh too, which was really weird. My best guess for where it was buried, by the way, was right here. Kind of looks like a patch, doesn't it? And I do have the shovel. But, nope. Anyway, the school extension isn't built over it, so I don't even know how that could possibly be the solution. But yeah. Alright, let's see the last memory. I really did want to 100% it. Oh well.
Restorer, I need to make this absolutely clear. If you leave and go to the final memory now, there's no coming back. So if there's anything you think you've missed or want to explore further, I suggest you do it now.
Oh god, that just makes me want to stay even more. But no, it's not. I'm not enjoying it anymore. I'm just wandering around for 30 minutes, making literally no progress whatsoever, staring at the same things I've stared at before. It's not good. That's not a good use of my time. No, I'm just gonna go. Just gonna go. By the way, I did make an extra save in a separate slot. So if I ever want to come back, it's always there. Oh god, I changed my mind. I want to go back. I'm actually curious. Can I go back? Whoa. What the fuck?
I think... Oh.
Wait, what?
We're back here. I thought that would have been it, but... Just one second. What the hell is going on?
Wait. I was just poking at the limits of the game to see whether it actually allowed me to go back, because she said I... You know, this is it. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and load this game.
Now, there's no coming back. So if there's anything you think you've missed or want to explore further, I suggest you do it now.
It's incredibly dark in here. Way darker than it was before. Taking a picture of that teleports me here. I can go outside. Whoa. God, that noise still scares me. Jesus. Oh, I forgot about it. I forget about it every time. Hold on, is there something to do over there? It doesn't seem to be. Alright, I don't even remember where I came in from. How do I leave? Oh, here we go. It's the lighthouse. One hell of a storm, too. It's giving me serious Bioshock vibes.
Everything you see, just recognize these beautiful items that you found. You need to accept who you are. I'm not your enemy, Thomas. I'm trying to help you. The things we touch in life stay with us. Although broken and fragmented, they hold the key to remembering the way we used to be. The scent of a perfume, a memorable song. It's important that you fight. You need to let go of this dream world.
Here again.
You need to hold on to her. You need to hold on to your memories. That's all that you have left. You need to fight this illness. I'm just a manifestation, a reinterpretation of someone who's actually trying to help you. Please, it's time.
Again. It keeps popping up, again and again. Our little safe space.
She's waiting for you up there. Jean, at the top. At the light, where the answers you seek are waiting for you. Go! Go now!
Thomas. I guess the last question to answer is, how do I fit into all of this? In your memories and in your mind? All your friends from the neighborhood were here. This was the happiest day of your life. It doesn't affect everyone in the same way. He was never violent to either of you. But the soul can be crushed in other ways. And he emotionally drained you both. Too much, too young, too soon. I wanted you to come and live with us across the road. Somewhere I knew you'd be safe. I was at your birthday party, Thomas. Sat there in the garden, you remember? You noticed me and bought me a piece of cake. Always caring. They did care about you though, Thomas. Remember your fifth birthday party? She spent hours wrapping your presents and baking your cake. You watched her as she prepared everything. You were so excited. You knew she loved you. In fact, you never questioned that at all. The empathy of a child is a very powerful thing. It wasn't long till he was consumed by intoxication. He was warned and still he continued. How were you meant to know he was going to go away as well? You just watched him stagger in every evening, always ensuring he got to bed and was safe. I also saw your mother leave that night, watching through my curtains as she drove away. I could always see your home and everything that happened inside. These memories aren't happy, Thomas, but they are important. They shaped you into who you are today. They made you human. St. Paul's Lighthouse. You climbed down and headed there. You went to hide, your father's lamp to light your way. You could only think of one place that you might be safe. And it wasn't with them. But she had to leave that day. She had to get out of there. Still, she should have taken you with her. You watched from up here, wanting her to just stop and come back. You didn't understand why she was leaving, but you knew she had to. She wasn't happy, and she couldn't be a wife to a drunk. Too many times he came in late. Too many times he just didn't care. They did love each other once, when they were young. He was a romantic, and she fell for him. He was always unaware, without a care in the world, lost in his own misery, unable to care for you. Night after night, week after week, month after month. Taking you away, or where? A lost soul in a sea of uncertainty. Frightened and scared. You know, you always were a wonderful artist. Yet, these memories are all yours. Everyone an experience from your life. Some of them we were together, and others only you experienced. Lost in your own illness, your mind fought to save as much as it possibly could by creating this confused world of fantasy and reality. These core memories from your childhood, they made you who you are today, traumatic as they are. But it truly was the only way that you could understand who you are as an individual. You're being treated with validation therapy, and you're struggling to feel alive. Sat in that leather chair, in that care home, day in, day out. I don't know why, but I decided to follow you. I grabbed my coat and I sneaked out the back door to head to the lighthouse too. I held your hand as we both hid by the old lighthouse. You told me to leave you alone, but I stayed, and I held your lamp for you, waiting for them to come to take you away, to the orphanage. That was the last time I saw you for a very long time. But it wasn't the last time I held your hand. I always wanted to find you, and I did. I did find you, all those years later. It's time we face this. Please, Thomas, sit down.
Fletcher? Mr. Fletcher? Thomas? Hello, it's me, Dr. Edmonds. You want me to sit? Okay, let me just grab a chair. I've bought two of your favorite things today. Sorry, what was that, Thomas? Oh, of course I'll hold your hand. Would you like to see what I've brought you? Let's look at this one first. I think it'll mean a lot to you. Oh, Thomas. Oh, let me wipe those tears. Does this lamp mean something? Of course. Of course you can. Here. Did your father give you this lamp, Thomas? Is that why it's important to you? Thomas, I can't quite hear you.
That's not why it's important.
Why is it so important?
Because my wife, she kept it for me. For all those years when I was taken away from here.
From Pinwheel?
Yes. I want to see her.
Thomas, I... When did you last see Jean?
I saw her. I'm sure...
Well, you've done very well today, Thomas. I do have another item for you, though. I think this will help you remember. I mean, I hope it will.
To
wind it up for you. Okay, here it goes.
This is so beautiful. I wish Jean was here to listen. I wish she didn't to go so soon.
Oh, Thomas. Let's listen together then, shall we?
Whew. That was one hell of an ending. It's a lot to absorb. Alright, well, I think I'm gonna split my thoughts of this game off into a separate video. So, I'm just going to say, I hope you enjoyed my playthrough of Aether 1, and thank you for watching.